Hello, and thank you for joining us for the Pomona Concert Band and the Ganesha Park Summer Concert Series, a tradition since 1947. Today's show is an American Jubilee, which features American music for the 4th of July long weekend holiday. You can join us in person for the next free summer concert, Thursday night at the Ganesha Park Band Shell, White and McKinley Avenue, just south of the fairgrounds. Showtime is 7:30. Tonight, our announcer is Mayor Tim Sandoval. Now, let's begin with conductor Linda Taylor and the color guard of the flag of the United States.
To present you with some music we think you will enjoy. But first, it is my extreme pleasure to introduce our color guard for this evening. United States Air Force retired Senior Master Sergeant Eddie Feliciano. United States Army retired Specialist 5th Class Thomas Laffey. United States Army Active Staff Sergeant Anthony Studnika. Would you please join us as we honor America under Ms. Linda Taylor's baton? Thank you. very much. Thank you. As you know, each week we invite a guest master of ceremonies. But we're getting pretty used to this guy now, so I don't know. I don't think he's a guest anymore. I think he's kind of almost an MC in residence. Does that make sense? We would be lost without the support of the city of Pomona, making this all possible. And who better than to be the MC of our first concert than the mayor of Pomona, the Honorable Ken Sandoval. We are still in labor negotiations. Good evening. And belated, happy 4th of July. All right, yeah, there you go. You can talk it out. This is the first of nine concerts. First of nine concerts of our very own Pomona Concert Band. So please, we encourage you to invite as many of your friends, your neighbors, please bring them here. So tonight's program is called an American Jubilee. An American Jubilee is a very special concert featuring American composers and arrangers. We are blessed to have so many U.S. born composers and arrangers in which to choose. The newer ones that we will feature tonight have the special ability to write music that definitely shows off the wind band at its best. First up, an American Fanfare by Rick Kirby. The melody used in an American Fanfare is, I think you know this one, My Country Tis of Thee. What comes after? Very good. Also known as America. This American patriotic song, whose lyrics were penned by Sandoval Smith, is derived from the British national anthem, God Save the Queen. In an American Fanfare, the composer has taken this normally hymn-like and stately melody and incorporated it into a fast and hard-driving fanfare. The actual melody is sung only once. Many liberties are taken with both the melodic and harmonic elements of the original piece. Linda conducts. Thank you.
O Magnum, Mysterium, by Morten, Lauridsen, and arranged by H. Robert Reynolds. I want to apologize to all of you who are UCLA fans, because there's quite a bit of reference to USC. This is traditionally known as a choral piece. It means "Oh Great Mystery" and refers to the birth of Jesus. Dr. Lauridsen is a professor emeritus at USC. He only retired recently and is still actively composing. H. Robert Reynolds, who arranged this for the band, worked closely with Dr. Lauridsen on this arrangement. Mr. Reynolds is also a professor at USC. And then they confess.
Thank you.
Resplendent Glory by Rossano, Gallante. Mr. Gallante, a New York native, moved to California in 1999 to study film scoring at where else? USC. And has done the score for numerous films in Hollywood. Resplendent Glory is a romantic, heroic composition. So is anybody here with a significant other? This is an opportunity for a little romance. And a hug, or keep it close to you. The main theme of the work begins immediately by the trumpets and is then passed to the woodwinds and horns. The B theme is then stated by the trombones and supported by the woodwinds, and we're talking about musical instruments here. The C theme has a lush melody stated by the woodwinds and horns. The main melody returns with a full ensemble, ending with a big climax with brass fanfares and woodwind flourishes. Linda conducts.
Thank you.
always nice to know who we have in the audience. Do we have anybody here from the city of Pomona? Just raise your hand nice and high. Okay. Yeah, can you hear? Anybody from Claremont? Welcome, Claremont. How about Laverne? All right, how about somebody who's from out of state? Just raise your hand. Oh, welcome to California. I'm sure you're enjoying this weather. All right. Variation, oh, anybody outside of the areas that I mentioned, just raise your hand. Welcome as well. Thank you. Variations on a Korean folk song by John Barnes Chance. John Barnes Chance only lived 40 years, but in that short time, he made a big name for himself in the concert band world. When he was in the U.S. Army in Korea, he became enamored with the Korean folk song, Our Land, and it is the basis of his composition. Chance composed this piece in 1965, and it became his best known work. It is in six sections. The theme is heard followed by five variations. Variation one features temple blocks and various other percussion instruments. Variation two is quiet and serene with the oboe playing the theme inverted. Variation three is a fast march. Variation four is solemn. And the fifth is a recap of the theme by various sections of the band. And you will be tested on this at the end. We ask that you please hold the applause until the end. George conducts.
Thank you.
Band of Liberty by John Wasson. Band of Liberty was composed to highlight and celebrate our nation's history through the use of several well-known patriotic folk songs, and to Columbia, Gem of the Ocean, provides the frame of the work inside which some other tunes are introduced. Columbia and Yankee Doodle are presented in contemporary March people, while Chester, America the Beautiful, and America are treated in lush ballad forms. At the end, America the Beautiful and America are superimposed upon one another, while fragments of the other works are utilized as decorations and flourishes leading to the dramatic ending. You'll actually have to listen to them perform to really understand what I just said. After this piece, we'll take a 15-minute intermission. Please enjoy some refreshments from the snack bar, and don't forget to feed the hungry tuba. Let's say that together. The hungry tuba. And also be sure to get your 50-50 tickets to the drawing after the break. Linda conducts. Thank you. American Elegy by Frank Ticheli. This piece is an expression of hope. It was composed in memory of those who lost their lives in the Columbine High School tragedy in 1999, to honor the survivors. The work begins at the bottom of the band's register and descends gradually to a heartfelt cry of hope. Next, a more serene, lyrical side of the piece is stated by the horns, and next, a more poignant mood. These three moods, hope, serenity, and sadness, become intertwined throughout the work, defining its complex, expressive character. The music recedes, and a trumpeter is heard, suggesting a celestial voice, perhaps a heavenly message. The full band returns in the end with a final exalted statement of the main theme. We dedicate this piece tonight to the other schools who have since suffered the same type of tragedy that Columbine did. Hope should remain eternal. Then they conduct.
Thank you.
Commando March by Samuel Barber. Highly regarded as one of the cornerstone marches in the wind band repertoire. Commando March remains Barber's only published work for the band. Barber was one of the titans of 20th century American music. Commando March was written while Barber was in the Army in 1942. Do we have any servicemen and women here with us tonight? Just raise your hand. Let's give them a nice big hand for their service. Thank you. The march was completed in 1943, and even though it has a large instrumentation, Barber always referred to this piece as his little march, George Conducts.
Thank you.
West Side Story selection by Leonard Bernstein and arranged by W.J. Cooper. Growing up as a kid, I remember listening to what some people call lowriders. I didn't really have much exposure to classical music except for Bugs Bunny. That was my exposure. And it wasn't until a friend in my early 20s invited me to go to the Broken Camera Pavilion. And it was to see West Side Story, Leonard Bernstein. And I was smitten from that day. And over the years, I've had the chance of working for an amazing program that was I co-founded with others called Bright Process. It's helped see over 3,000 kids go to the Hollywood Bowl over the last 15 years to experience classical music. And so I am forever grateful to Bugs Bunny. And I'm forever grateful to my friends who got to take me to the Dorothy Chandler Pavilion, something I really hadn't been exposed to. Selections from West Side Story by Leonard Bernstein is truly an American musical, if there ever was one. Gang robbery and a great love story. West Side Story is based on Romeo and Juliet. Leonard Bernstein's music always has depth and singable melodies, which is rare these days. Tonight you will hear these familiar songs, I Feel Pretty, Maria, Somewhere, Tonight, One Hand, One Heart, Something's Coming, Cool, and America. We honor Leonard Bernstein's centennial birth year tonight. George conducts. Thank you.
Thank you. Give him a nice big hand. I'd like to just take a moment to honor, if I acknowledge, as I said, my good friend and colleague, who is the city council member for District 1, Rubio Gonzalez. So give him a nice big hand. National Fencibles March by Gallante of Sousa. The National Fencibles, of this march's title, were a popular drill team in Washington, D.C. The words to the trio of the march reflect their esprit de corps. Forward to the battle, the trumpet is sounding. Shoulder to shoulder, with hearts rebounding. Onward we march with the Fencibles swing. This march was written in 1888, which also happens to be the year that the city of Pomona was incorporated. And then they can rest. Thank you. We now end our concert with America the Beautiful, arranged by Carmen. We hope you will be sure to come back next week. The British are coming. No, not the Beatles. We will feature music and composers from the British Isles. Also, be sure to come and hear the Claremont Symphony Orchestra this Sunday at 7 p.m. right here on this stage.
Doing America Beautiful this season, most of the time anyway, is our newly appointed assistant conductor, Carrie Palmer.
That was Pomona Mayor Tim Sandoval and the Pomona Concert Band in live performance at Ganesha Park. Catch next week's concert at 7:30 on Thursday night. Be sure to visit the Pomona Concert Band website at pomonaconcertband.org and make a donation with the convenient PayPal button. An American Jubilee was recorded as a public service of Magnolia Street Productions, available for live shows at school or at work. See you next week. For the Pomona Concert Band, this is Tim Greenwood speaking.